Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will not be dealing with the lead editorial, and the reason for that is I have already dealt with the topic that has come in today's lead editorial. In this class I will be dealing with another important topic, a new issue that is germinating in the agriculture sector that is related to BT cotton issue. Now, the yield of cotton depends upon how many insects have infested a particular crop and how many weeds have infested the particular crop. So if we want to have higher yield from the cotton, we need to protect the cotton from the insects. We need to protect the cotton from insects and the weeds. Now, because India is a tropical country, being a tropical country, it is prone to lot of insects and it is prone to lot of development of weeds. So in India, this BT cotton was introduced in year 2002. When this BT cotton was introduced in India, it has given a big push to the yields in the crop from cotton. Now in 2002 we had introduced first generation, now this is very important, first generation of BT cotton. Later on, second generation of BT cotton was introduced, and now we are also talking about introducing the third generation of BT cotton. Now what is this first, second and third generation of BT cotton? The first generation of BT cotton means you have altered or you have modified the genes of the cotton seed, and by altering and modifying the genes of the cotton seed, we get unique qualities out of the cotton crop, because of which the insects which infest on the cotton crop, they actually die. Now the biggest culprit of the cotton yield is the pink bollworm. Now it is the pink bollworm primarily which we had wanted to fight by using this first generation of BT cotton when we had introduced it in year 2002. जब हमने इसको introduce कराया, उसके बाद में इस pink bollworm ने एक resistance develop कर लिया against the first generation of BT cotton that we had introduced, and later on the need was felt to introduce the second generation of BT cotton. So second generation of BT cotton ko introduce karaya gaya, but again pink bollworm is again developing the resistance against this BT cotton, hybrid BT cotton seeds. So what should India be doing for this? So this is the issue that has actually cropped up, because in order to use this BT cotton, the farmers need to pay to the companies like Monsanto and Myco. Now because this yield crops, they are very, this hybrid crops, they are very expensive, and already the resistance is getting developed against the insects, and the farmer has to invest more on weedicides. That is the another negative of this BT cotton that we have introduced. Now India's case is quite peculiar with respect to BT cotton. Now, what is this peculiarity that I'm talking about? Now, if you compare India's agriculture sector and especially India's BT cotton with that of the BT cotton that has been introduced in China or in Australia or in the United States of America, in those countries, the cotton, the BT cotton, that have not developed, this pink bollworm have not developed resistance to this first generation or second generation of BT cotton. वहाँ पे pink bollworm खत्म हो जाता है जब हम BT cotton का seed sow करते हैं field में. But हिंदुस्तान में pink bollworm ने resistance develop कर लिया है. Now what are the reasons? First of all, we'll be understanding the reasons behind it. Now the first important reason is pink bollworm ने resistance क्यों पैदा कर लिया है? अगर हम cotton crop को देखते हैं, तो cotton crop का एक length है. कितनी देर तक cotton crop को हम उसका yield लेंगे उससे. Now when it comes to India, जो हम cotton को sow करते हैं, वो हम long season perspective से उसको sow किया जाता है. Long season. Now what is the meaning of long season? So once the crop of the cotton is sown, it takes about 16 to 20 months in India. Now this is very, very important. So we keep on delaying this crop and we sow it for a longer period of time. We don't cut the crop. But as far as the Western countries are concerned, USA is concerned, China is concerned, and Australia is concerned, the crop is sown just for a short period of time. Because it is sown for a short period of time, like for 12 months or for 14 months, the resistance capacity of the bollworm doesn't develop in this shorter period of time. Now this is one of the most important reasons. So if in India we want that the pink bollworm should not be developing the resistance, हमें जो cropping season है, जो cotton का cropping season है, उसको छोटा करना पड़ेगा. अगर हम उस season को बड़ा रखेंगे, तो pink bollworm एक resistance develop कर लेगा against BT cotton. Now the second biggest reason is that in India, most of the area that we are having, tentatively about 40% of the area over which this BT cotton is used, it has developed more resistance. And the reason for that is this 40% of the area that is sown by the BT, it is actually of hybrid quality. Now this is very important, hybrid quality. It is not open pollinated quality. Now what is the difference between open pollinated and hybrid? Now the open pollinated means जब आपने BT cotton का seed develop किया, जब वो open pollinated quality है, आपने उसको इस तरह से genetic engineering से bioengineering से उसको develop किया है, you actually allow that seed to forward its quality to the next seed that can be used in the next session. But as far as the hybrid seed is concerned, you actually kill that property. You actually hinder, now this is very important, you actually hinder the passing of the qualities to the next generation of seeds. To the next generation, ek seed se jab dusra seed develop hota hai, to hybrid BT cotton mein wo qualities pass nahi ho paata hai. On the other hand, jab ek seed se dusre seed mein conversion hoga, jab open pollinated way se hoga, to quality transfer ho jayega. To yahan pe quality transfer nahi hota, to maximum of the farmers kya karte hai, kyunki BT cotton ka seed bahut mehenga hai. Mehenga hone ke karan ek bar field mein usko laga liye, next year what they will try to do is they will try to reuse the seed. So reusing that seed from the hybrid quality will not have that quality by which they could develop the qualities to fight this pink bollworm. So pink bollworm ko fight nahi kiya ja sakta us reduced quality mein, because maximum is hybrid. Kyunki Indian farmer paisa nahi dena chahta tha, usi ko reuse karta hai. Aur Indian farmer long season promote karta hai cotton farming mein. rather the period should be short ताकि pink bollworm से हम fight करते रहें. So this was all for this class. Now for more insights on BT cotton, you can download the question and answer series of Brainy IES from our application IES Buzz. I've already dealt with this question in detail. So you can go through that question and answer series. That will really help you in understanding this and getting more insight about this topic. So this topic was a bit technical, but this is a very important development that is unfolding in India. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IES. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.